What, you gonna flask me a question
now? I'm gonna flask you a question. Oh man, what should I do? Who was shit, I wasn't prepared, Aaron. Who was the princess in Zelda?
The princess in Zelda?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, who was the princess in Zelda, bitch?
Princess Peach.
No. That's wrong. Flask.
Fuck.
It was Link.
Fuck, I knew that!
I know. You should have known that. It was totally Link the entire time.
Is that good enough?
Basically, Link was a bitch anyways.
That's it.
Welcome to Experience Pints.
Welcome to Experience Pints. I'm your host, Billy Wonka. With me today, I have Baron Alexander and Kunjaki Armstrong. And on the couch with us tonight, we got a little tiny Black Panther, apparently. Not the radical group based on race, but a actual tiny little creature of pantherness. Welcome to Experience Pints.
I don't know how I feel about the way that we started this show.
Can we start over again?
No.
Okay.
We can continue.
We can continue. 9, 8, 7. Put a quarter in. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Experience Pints. Aaron Alexander. Billy Wong. And CJ Cut Jockey Armstrong. We are Experience Pints.
Experience Pints.
Welcome to Experience Pints.
Welcome to Experience Pints.
I'm your host, Billy Wonka. Not to be confused with Willie, the richer, more famous cousin. With me, I have Aaron Alexander. Say hello, Aaron.
Hi.
Not... Okay.
I'm not supposed to say hi to the camera?
No, you are, but...
How did you want me to do this?
Well,
host?
I wanted to do it too, and I didn't. Now I feel stupid because you did. Hi. Okay.
Hi.
CJ?
Hi.
Armstrong. He didn't wave the camera. There we go. Guys, it's been actually 2 weeks now since we've been on the video.
It's been 2 weeks since you looked at me.
God. No, really, we had technical difficulties last time that inhibited us from being able to be seen visually. We had a guy on, whatever his name was, Bill Girth, I don't know. He was pretty cool, dude.
I think it was Gilworth.
Yeah, he was pretty cool, dude. It was whatever.
Pretty cool, dude.
Pretty cool, dude.
He was pretty awesome, in my opinion.
I agree.
Cut. Cut. Stop.
What did I do? Just leave it rolling. Oh, he's got to go pee. I saw him grabbing his dick as he was running down there. So, CJ.
What's up, man?
What's been going on?
Nothing. Trying to play L.A. Noir for once.
L.A. Noir?
Noir. Well,
Noir.
Noir.
Oh, yeah. What's going on with that?
I wouldn't make a good detective.
You wouldn't make a good detective?
Nah.
Are you failing the challenges or the...
questions part.
How's that going?
Pretty horrible. I'm trying to tell whether they... Well, I know when they lie. I'm just picking the right evidence.
By all their facial expressions and shit. Yeah.
No, you tell when they lie, when they ain't looking at you, when they look around. Kind of like how you're doing.
I'm sorry, I'm not lying right now, though.
Sirs, pass down. Sorry about that. Forget the most essential part of Experience Pints. It's mine.
This is the most essential part?
This has my name on it.
I think our viewers are our most essential part.
Well, they wouldn't have anything to watch if we didn't do this thing properly. As tradition goes, every week we drink something different. And for the third week in a row, I've been in charge of doing the beering duties.
This is third week.
Well, fourth. No, third, because you did the first two.
Okay.
Brown sugar and...
Brown sugar, we had...
Rogue. Some fancy shit.
Oh, yeah, the fancy
Actually,
shit.
The bottle is right there beside you on the chessboard. This week, I have two... Actually, I have three beers, but we'll save these 40s for later. Now I got two pop...
40s?
Yeah, you know I'm fancy like that. Today we have...
It's not Colt 45, is it?
No. Put that on the GoPro.
What is this?
Mississippi Fire Ant Imperial Red Ale.
Just reading it from this direction, I thought it said flatulence.
You know, it's kind of, it throws you off when you first look at it because it kind of looks like some kind of bug spray, which knows going to fuck you up. So that's a really good idea. Never mind. I'll take that back. It's an awesome marketing plan. Gonna raid on the store that has this.
Wow. Yeah. See what you did there.
All right, let's do this.
Let's live the bug's life.
Oh, well. I know. You know who really loves this beer? My aunt. Ha ha! Oh, it is pretty fucking red.
Is this Fire Ant? Is that what it was called?
Yeah, it's called Mississippi Fire Ant. Southern.
It kind of doesn't smell good.
Yep, I've been feeling this may be bad.
This reminds me of brown sugar a bit. Oh,
God damn it, no.
You smell that?
I smell it.
I'm...
Still got that steampunk beer from this past weekend. All right, guys. Let's experience these pints.
Prohibition is the company that makes this.
Well, that seems legitimate.
Let's do it. Ready? All right. Are we going to cheers off?
I already did with CJ.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't really
want to exclude me.
I want to touch your glass.
Shouldn't you cheers the host of the show?
I did. I pour my own goddamn beer. They should have kept this prohibited. They should have never fucking broken the law to produce this. This is terrible. And basically, fuck, I'm drinking what I think a speakeasy smells like. Cigarette butts and potpourri.
Cigarette butts and potpourri.
Basically every grandmother's house in the late 90s. Jesus. Literally, don't knock.
How about you, CJ? What do you think of the taste?
It's not my favorite.
No, it's not.
We ain't really had many good beers since I've been on the show.
I got a couple more to kind of.
What was last week's? Last week's was decent.
No, last week's was great. Sucked. It was Palm.
What was the last week? Was Palm?
Yeah. Was Palm the Palm one was that was good. Actually good?
Yeah,
or was it the birthday light. Cake or whatever?
Birthday cake was fire.
I bought more birthday cake. I have a 6-pack of birthday cake ready to cut.
So what was that beer we had that really didn't taste like nothing?
That was it's over there too. Burt's Bees.
Boddington's Pub Ale.
Boddington's Pub Ale.
Burt's Bees. And we never did cut that can open. We need to take care of that later on. It's like Bansky's beer, you know, shaking a spray can.
Mm.
Somebody get that
speaking.
Joke. Somebody get that joke. Thank you, audience, clapping silently at your
speaking
table.
Of like shaking the paint can. Did you ever play? You remember an infamous?
I thought you were about to go into the headline as what it read today about that girl who died at 15 because she got shooken as a kid. Oh man, that would have been a really dark path to take. What were you gonna say?
Wow.
They had to pull the plug. Go ahead, man.
No way. I thought the same thing, though.
Yeah. See?
Really?
Yeah.
I guess I need to, like, pay attention to my social media feed and not sleep all fucking day.
Well, we need to, like, start shaking those cans of beer for SIDS awareness.
SIDS awareness?
Yes. We're starting a new thing. We're just shaking up beers and drinking them for awareness of SIDS. Wait, is that not sudden infant death syndrome? Shaking baby syndrome. SBS. Yeah. That's what we're going to do. SIDS is totally different thing. I take that
out. I'm not sure how I feel about this campaign.
It's like better than like the whole ice bucket thing. Instead of dousing yourself in cold water, you're just cracking up your beers.
We're going to shake something for the shaken babies.
Yeah. Well, no, it's not like that's not that bad of a thing. It's a totally terrible.
No, it's not that bad. Of a thing makes it bad of a thing.
It's a pretty terrible thing, isn't it? The more
it's
I think about it,
it's kind of really bad.
It's not that bad. I mean, I've said other things that are way worse.
If you had the campaign be that you line up the fathers that shook their babies, you shake them.
You can't do a Facebook or YouTube vid of that. I said vid on purpose. Vid. Or a viral video of that with a hashtag attached to it. It's like, it's too long. You got to go get the dad, shake him. And that's against the law. You shake a beer, it opens up and explodes.
No, because
like,
that's what happens to their brains, partner
man.
With law enforcement. And you go to these prisons where they've locked up these dads that are shaking their babies.
They've already been arrested. They're stopped. You can't. They're already prosecuted by the.
That doesn't,
sent to
that
the
doesn't
law.
Stop.
We need to do
that
more.
That doesn't stop.
We need to do more to keep this from happening. I think shaking up beers is a perfect fucking caveat to start this.
No, it's not.
Yes,
and I think
is.
We need to stop talking about it. I'm feeling bad on the inside for the shaken babies. Babies that have been shaken is not funny.
No, it's not. No, it's not. Especially if they're marijuana babies, like their mom was smoking a lot when she was pregnant.
You're going to hell.
They'd be just shaking baked babies.
Okay. So, this was a perfect transition into the fact that.
Oh my god!
Fuck! What's that game that's free?
I broke CJ.
What's that?
I broke CJ. We're 5 minutes into this and he's already broken. Look at him.
You're breaking me, dude. And it's tough to break me. But no, I'm PlayStation Plus right now. Can't you download
Transistor?
No. Well, you can download Transistor
in February.
But to transition easier. What's the game with the baby that
Binding of Isaac?
Yeah, Binding of Isaac is free on PlayStation Plus
right now. To be fair, he's not quite
a
baby. He's a child.
Okay.
He's a child. He's a child.
Is he?
Yeah, he's a child. Like he's like.
Doesn't he wear a diaper?
No. He was.
He doesn't have a diaper?
Playing game. He was playing with toys and stuff, and his mom like got religious and took it all away. He's like a kid.
I was playing video games when I was still shitting on myself. And by that, I mean I still shit on myself.
I was about to say, last week doesn't count, but whatever. You already beat me to it. Wow. Okay. So you're talking about Binding of Isaac. That's video games. That's a lot better of a direction than where we were going before.
Yeah.
2012. All right. Speaking of Binding of Isaac and platformers, well, that's actually a roguelike. But their legacy kind of goes back to Super Meat Boy in some ways. And there's a baby in Super Meat Boy, Dr. Fetus. You can't tell me. No. No. I'm actually going to stop myself. I'm not going to go there. I'm not going to go there.
That could have been the best part. Wherever, whatever direction you were about to head in, one direction.
Yeah, basically. All right. Got to stop myself from that one. That one was bad. Oh, my God. Wow. Wow. So video games?
So we've reached a new low.
Yeah, I know. Speaking of new lows, I actually went pretty low this week with video game playing.
What is your new low?
Well, I actually purchased a video game. I bought Saints Row Reelected Edition.
It comes not Gat Out of Hell?
It comes with Gat Out of Hell.
Okay.
It's the PC version of Saints Row 4 on new consoles.
Not the politically the correct version.
Let's see. Okay, there we go. Yeah, well, it's nothing's politically nothing. That game is about as bad as me.
Right.
It looks just as good as the PC version, but it comes with the Gat Out of Hell, which is a new expansion, about $20 standalone. So if you
pay, is it terrible?
No, it's actually not that bad.
Doesn't it look really bad though?
No, it looks all right. It doesn't look fantastic or anything, but I think it's pretty funny. There's a lot of monster trucks in hell, and there's like a lot of tormented souls mindlessly walking around, which really isn't all that different from pedestrians in the first place. So. It's kind of a funny satire on people in a lot of ways. It's basically Saints Row 4, except you have like wings and you can fly around. I haven't played too much of it. A lot of the weapons are pretty cool.
So you're even more godly than you were in Saints Row 4?
Hellishly so. Hellishly so.
Do they have to change directions every time that you actually go to a storyline mission versus how powerful you
really
are in the regular?
I haven't really done much of the story stuff. I just started. I know that Ultor's involved. Ultor's in hell. Like, the corporation is in hell now. Ultor being from Red Faction, which has always been tied into Saints Row games.
Really? I didn't know that.
It was the same guys, or was, until after THQ shut down, the rights to Red Faction actually were sold off. So Volition, people who used to make Red Faction games, no longer have the rights to Red Faction. They only have Saints Row. Yeah.
I did not know that.
That sucks because they did so good with Guerrilla. Not so much Thormageddon, but Gorilla was awesome.
Yeah, that almost disappoints me that you don't see more like destruction in the video game.
That game was amazing. And, you know, that's something that may come back up with the next Saints Row. I think if they were to go bigger.
Think environment destruction?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it'd make sense. That would be a unique direction for that genre of video game, the whole like Grand Theft Auto look. If you could like destroy buildings with rocket launchers and wreck cars in
they
the
know
buildings
how to do
and
it.
Like.
They know how right. to make it. I mean,
that's like
love to
what
see
they're
it.
Known for.
I want to see it again. Like this new generation of consoles. You don't have, okay, the graphics were never fantastic, but they were clean. They were crisp. They ran at really fast speeds and looked good for what it was.
I would actually a halt to the direction of graphically better in video games if they would start adding things like
water,
attention to world detail, and stuff like
damage. Yeah,
damage staying forever.
Yeah, or enough to look cool. Like Battlefield 4 and 3 both look great. They're great-looking games, but the destruction's always sucked to me.
Right, and then the vehicles disappear and whatever.
Well, I mean, that's one thing. That's like online gaming. But I'm talking about the destruction of things sucks because you only destroy certain things. And when you do blow up something, a lot of times it's just a palette swap. Smoke, and then like there's a different graphic put in place of it. So it's not like really super fucking cool. And I like Bad Company 2.
Bad Company 2.
Knocking out pieces of walls and shit.
Bad Company 2, you could level
anything. We talked about this before on the podcast, and I started thinking about it again. Yeah, Bad Company 2 was fucking awesome.
Bad Company 2
had a cool story
best.
Mode too, man. I actually kind of liked the campaign they had attached to it. Wasn't lame like I thought it was going to be.
The thing that I've always liked about the Battlefield campaigns is that they were always harder than other first-person shooter games.
Yeah.
Like, you can't play that game on the hardest setting and not fucking die.
Yeah.
Or is Call of Duty if... Yeah.
Veterans kind of bitchy in some spots. Especially, what's that? The Maha Club is the achievement for the very end of 4. Like, after the credits in the airplane.
Oh.
Yeah. And you play that on Veteran, it's really fucking hard.
Yeah.
It's really fucking hard.
Those Spec Ops missions and shit were
fucking
awesome.
You remember Spec Ops missions?
The one Call of Duty, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that.
I think we all wasted a lot of time hungover on that couch down there. Actually, this couch is down there at the time, so no, it wasn't. That's before you guys.
The sniper mission.
Oh, fuck that.
Spec Ops sniper.
The Spec Ops one with the fucking gas station. We had to hold off for different waves of enemies in the Modern Warfare 2.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. It's kind of weird.
Fuck.
It's kind of weird because today I saw somebody make a post on the interwebs. Remember the good old days? It's pictures of multiplayer maps from Modern Warfare 2, which is weird that people at this point are getting nostalgic. It was a long time ago, but it's kind of weird.
A while ago now.
You're nostalgic for a place that you've never been, but you know every inch and corner. Because digital world you used to run around in. I played a lot of Modern Warfare 2 online.
When did Nuketown come up? Was that Modern Warfare 2?
That was Black Ops 1.
Black Ops
was it? That was a good game.
Fucking right, man.
The fucking numbers. What do the numbers mean, Mason? What do they mean?
Focus, Mason. We're out of fucking time. The world is on the fucking brink of war.
Whose war? Who the fuck are you anyway? Huh? God, I just keep hearing the fucking numbers.
Metal Gear.
Sorry.
Resident Evil 4.
It's always been
Resident Evil.
Resident Evil 4. That was, speaking of, glad we came to that, I actually purchased and played the Resident Evil HD remake. My first non-Resident Evil 4 and 5 Resident Evil.
So you'd never played Resident Evil 1?
No. I tried in the past. I hated it.
So what you think about it?
Holy shit, it's not aged well at all. But
it's not aged well.
No, it's slow, plotting. Survival horror is not my thing, but the door opening animation could have been taken out, I think.
I thought that was kind of goofy they left that in, but what they did take out was, and I don't remember if it was taken out in the GameCube version or not, but like when you go up and down stairs, there used to be an animation for going up and down stairs. Now you just go.
I think I remember that.
So like, you don't have to go through that.
Didn't they also change some things around
it too? It was...
I get what they're going for there. And I did meet that first zombie, which is totally recollected of, reminding me of The Order 1886, which is going to be coming out soon, and I'm looking forward to
that. Right, I think there's an animation that, I think that they lifted it from Resident Evil as like a reference.
Can you kill that first zombie with a fucking knife?
You can kill that first zombie.
How?
Now...
I got wrecked every fucking time.
You're playing as Chris?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, Chris has a knife. Jill starts out with a Beretta. So,
what's a hat going to do? I know. I'm just kidding.
I originally beat the game with Jill. I think I beat it with Chris on GameCube. So most of my memory is more based on Jill's storyline. So you would go in and you could kill it, but then it would come back to life. So it just does better to run from it because
I figured that out.
So you can run from it. Go through the door, and then Barry will be standing there, and he'll shoot it as Jill. Now, as Chris, Chris's storyline is a whole lot less forgiving.
There's different storylines.
Right.
Did not know that.
So as Jill, a lot of times Barry will save you from situations that would normally have wrecked your ass.
Was Barry, into her or something, or is that the...
Maybe. I don't know, but I think he's just more like... He's more like a father or a good brother figure.
He got friend zoned.
Yeah, he totally got friend zoned.
Resident What's up, Evil Paul? Friend zone.
No, but you've got so Jill would be the easier storyline. You start off, you've got more slots. You start out
more sluts.
The joke. Wow! Good Thank job, you, Paul.
Your speech on slots.
No,
are they looser slots?
The joke was always that a girl would have more places to keep things,
breast.
Yeah. Oh, so China. She, Chris started out with six inventory slots. She had eight. She started out with a Beretta.
That's bullshit. Have you seen women's pants? You can't fit a fucking cigarette lighter down there, let alone anything, dude.
No, right.
It's bullshit.
No, maybe she has a backpack. I don't know.
No, fanny pack. But, anyway. I'll sport one if I have to fucking survive.
Anyway.
If I'm in the military and I have guns strapped to me, I'll gladly wear a fanny pack. I'll wear a fanny pack on the next podcast. I'll buy a motherfucking fanny pack. Full of fucking jello shots.
Barry gives you a lock pick. A lot of doors can be picked with the lock pick at the beginning of the game.
Is there a mini game attached to that?
No.
Or just immediate. It's before that shit.
Yeah. You just got a lock pick. But yeah, you still have to go through things like there's a door here, but this wall's blown up to the right of you. And it goes, sorry, you can't get into this room because there's a door here or there's a window right next to this door. But I'm still blocked out from being able to get here.
I love video games.
Or you can't see anything down this hole. Do you wish to go down?
Yes, I do. Ladies.
What happened to the GoPro?
I have it right here looking at
me. Oh, I thought maybe Paul had knocked it off the table.
Knocked everything off. All right. Hitch! Good cash. Come in.
So, you were telling us that you played L.A. Noire?
Yes, sir.
Oh, did you buy that or did you borrow it from here?
I went ahead and got it.
You went ahead and got it? Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Well, it was $6.
Sure. I have Syndicate. Before you leave, you need to play Syndicate. And I do, anybody listening, highly recommend checking out Syndicate. It's on 360, PS3, and PC. It's awesome. It's on Origin because EA.
Because
it's an EA game?
Yeah, it's an EA game. EA published, so it's on Origin.
Fucking hate Origin.
Yeah.
They need to give up.
I went and I bought Crysis 3 recently on Origin, and it's the only way I can get it. For $20, which didn't want to do that, but it's never going to go on sale. And I'm glad I did because Crysis 3 is a really cool game. It's a lot better than I actually thought it was going to be. I always wrote it off because I played the 360 version. It looked like shit. So that's me. I already did my first game. You go into your game, and I got another one to talk about in a minute. But you played L.A. Noire.
I'm not a good detective.
I actually did really good at first. And I'm not trying to go, I'm smart.
No, I mean, I did good at first. It's like... I could tell when they're lying.
But then they start throwing you off.
When they start giving me I'm at the point where I get a shitload of clues and I have to choose which one it is.
Yeah.
That's the backup. You're lying. You did kill so-and-so. I prove it. And I got literally 15 fucking clues to choose from.
The benefit about that game, or the good thing about that game is you don't fail.
You just keep going. The story keeps moving along, even though you get chewed out.
I hate to fail, though.
By your Irish boss. I know, and I get it. You kind of want to get it right.
Well, I kind of... I consider that like a downfall of that game.
I consider it the only way to play that game. If they had it any other way, would you want to go back through that all over again?
Well, I agree with Aaron. The life is downfall, like real life situations. You mean you fuck up, you fuck up.
Yeah.
Well, it just discourages you from doing everything.
I didn't. I was involved in the storyline, or I was involved in the game. I wanted to try. And I fail, it's okay. I get my next case and I'll try better next time. Even though I know it's going to be harder, there's more pressure on me to get it right this time.
Well, what discouraged me was when I invested like an hour worth of like finding all the evidence and I got like the shit. And then I walked out this door and the storyline like skipped before, like the guy that I needed to interrogate's like in the front room. And I'm like going through and I'm getting all the evidence. I'm like, I'm going to fucking get this guy. Cause I had no idea that you could like fail and still succeed.
Right.
And so I'm like, oh dude, I got this guy. I'm getting ready to go interrogate him. But I went out the back door of this place and then a cinematic started that continued the storyline without me being able to interview him. And so I was like, this is fucking horse shit. I just spent an hour getting ready to slam this dude. Then I got no payoff. I just spent all my money at the bar trying to get ready for the end of the night. And then she didn't give me anything.
She turned out to be fake, non-existent.
Just drove off.
Yeah, no, she disappeared. Like she was like a ghost or something.
It happens.
It's ghost too. That's actually the other part of that story is that Patrick Swayze's character and Demi Moore's character break up, and he has to go on picking up bitches at the bar as a ghost. And whenever he gets back to the house, he realizes while he's ghost drunk that he can't ghost bone, so he just dissipates. And she turns around like, "What the fuck? I thought I was gonna get me some," but then he's a ghost. Well, actually, now he is a ghost, so I don't know. We should go. We should get him on the show.
Patrick Swayze,
yeah,
himself,
yeah.
And he's in character forever now.
He is. I mean, he is like. He's the most method actor. He's more method and method man he could ever want to be.
Wow.
Wait, Tom Cruise is not dead, right? Tom Cruise is still alive? Are we good?
We good, bro. All
right. I don't want the days of thunder raining upon me here. I don't need that shit. Oh, man.
Oh, that just happened.
I'm trying to think of other Patrick Swayze movies. I just can't think of anything but Roadhouse right now.
Roadhouse.
Never seen Roadhouse?
No, he was making a Peter Griffin Roadhouse reference.
Roadhouse.
I've never seen
Roadhouse.
I've never seen Family Guy.
Roadhouse.
That's a lie. Whoa, hey, back up. 2 seconds. Off of video games. They're doing a Ted 2.
I know. Yep. I saw a trailer for it yesterday.
Looked kind of funny.
Yep,
I shouldn't think that's funny. I think it should be the cheesiest, dumbest thing in the world.
I agree. I'll say the same thing.
But then, like, they take the role of him getting married, and then he has to prove the fact that he's a living creature. I was like,
oh, God, it's going to be deep. It's going to get serious.
It's going to get serious, but that's pretty funny, actually. There's, like, a lot you can do with that.
Yeah.
There's a lot you can do. Fucking right, dude. Because I saw that Million Ways to Die in the West.
Seth MacFarlane's kind of fucking genius.
Hey, no, you got a question.
A Million Ways to Die in the West isn't that good.
The main character Million Ways to Die in the West. Is anyone to voice Brian?
That's Seth MacFarlane. He does
Seth
Peter.
Yeah.
I know Brian. He does Peter.
He does Brian.
He does Brian.
Brian's more of his talking.
Brian, yeah.
Yeah, he's actually in Hellboy 2 also.
Yeah, I remember that.
That was pretty cool. He knew it was him, but he's a talented son of a bitch.
Yep.
He's an artist. He's a damn good voice actor just because he's so damn memorable with his characters. He came up with all the characters. And he actually managed to survive being canceled by Fox coming back. And look at him now.
Managed what?
So, you know, Family Guy got canceled by Fox a long time ago, and it stayed so popular.
Right, yeah. Because who bought it? Was it TBS that bought it, and then they started airing the old episodes?
Adult Swim was airing the old episodes before anybody else was.
Was it Adult Swim?
But it
there was,
on TBS
there was
too.
Some channel that renewed its popularity and its reason.
Nobody
can
purchase it. It was syndicated. So it was syndicated out to cable channels. That's when they get a small cut of them rerunning episodes. That's why, like, once a show goes syndicated, you're kind of set. Like, Friends was syndicated and Seinfeld is syndicated, and they still see a paycheck for all those episodes rerun.
Sure.
It's kind of crazy. They're just talking in front of a camera. Why do they get so much money?
I don't know. Well.
But anyways, away from that, L.A. Noire is a great game. I like the foot missions. I like seeing old L.A. I like seeing the 40s. I like using that call box for police that I totally does not. I do not understand how that works.
Tell us why we should play it again as a revisit. Tell us why that game should be remastered like everything else is being remade.
I don't think it should be remastered yet, though.
No. I think if Rockstar was going to go that route with remastering a whole bunch of video games, they should just throw Bully. They should just throw Bully, Red Dead. They should throw
Warriors.
The Warriors, Max Payne 3.
Grand Theft Auto 3.
Well, no.
I'm thinking
PS3, 360 games would be easier than remaster. Those four games, they're never going to make more sales on them. Why don't you just throw them in like one giant like Rockstar pack and send them out? I mean, maybe not Red Dead. They could actually do a lot with Red Dead.
Well,
I enjoy Red Dead.
You know, didn't they just confirm a Red Dead 2?
In some ways.
I'm pretty positive. Oh, they said that it's going to be a series. They said that's going to be a series that will continue. I mean, it started with Red Dead Revolver.
Well, that was a Capcom game.
Was it really
Capcom? But that is the series.
Yeah, Red Dead has nothing to do with each other.
It doesn't have anything to do with it.
I remember when Red Dead Revolver came out. I worked at the fucking video game store when it came out. And I remember
they had it on the PS2.
I didn't care. I was like, okay, whatever. I never even played it. I've never played Red Dead Revolver. Never. I never even seen it played, actually. Redemption, on the other hand, is kind of catchy in its own title because it kind of redeems whatever the fuck they were starting off with that. And I don't know why I guess it was popular enough to do that. But when it came to those Wild West games, I played Gun instead. And Gun sucked.
Yeah.
But it was cool at the time. It was one of those first like Xbox and 360 games.
Yep.
Yeah.
You got it because it was pretty. Kind of like everything that came out. Not last year, but the year before last.
It wasn't very pretty, though, man. It looked like an Xbox.
No, I'm just American saying, Wasteland, like, as far way. As, like, going from one generation to the next, it was one of the... It was kind of, like, black. Like, you're like, I gotta get this because it's, like, the prettiest
black
fucking thing.
Black was so cool, but sucked, because you shot red barrels the entire fucking time.
Really?
I mean, going back into that, I was really into Xbox games. Really into Xbox games. Back when it was starting to catch momentum. Before Black, there was a game called Full Spectrum Warrior. Never played it, but it was highly revered. And I'm surprised at this point. I've never seen a new Full Spectrum Warrior. It's not actually a shooter. It's more of like it's a cover-based military thing, but it's actually like, what's the term called? You take turns. It's turn-based. So you move and then you wait and your enemy takes a move. It's like
weird. RPG style.
Yeah, it's really weird, but people seem to love it. And there's like two of them.
And what is it? What view?
Full. It's third person. It did the whole behind the cover thing, okay. But it wasn't like Gears where you're snapping back and forth from cover like Killswitch did, but it was a big deal. I remember it came out at the same time PsyOps came. Remember PsyOps, anybody? It was the game where you controlled physics to do like pick up stuff. It was the first console game to really do it really, really cool.
What's this on?
Oh, Xbox and PS2. We should really do some more digging into those games one of these nights and actually go through a lot of this stuff because it's interesting to see how far we've come for a lot of these old games. You totally don't even know, like you don't even know these games exist. I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. They actually influenced a lot of things. I feel like Full Spectrum Warrior really, it came out in a time when there was no modern FPSs. It was all World War II. This is before Call of Duty 2. So this is still in the heyday of World War II shooters. So playing that, seeing that come out and get popular was pretty cool.
But when you talk about modern first-person shooters,
like modern-day warfare, like it was like a in the terrorist's homeland, putting America where it fucking belongs, in caves and people and villages and some goats. Some goats are really pretty. You can't deny it, boy.
The Goat and Goat Simulator.
Speaking of that, I have a child who's obsessed with Goat Simulator.
Oh yeah,
it's on iPad now. It's on fucking iPad.
Is it going to take off in some weird direction and like revitalize itself?
I don't know. There's a lot more to it now. Was that downloaded? Okay.
Right. So they're just tacking shit onto it.
First things first, with Steam, apparently the computer downstairs has Steam attached to it also. My account. I don't have to download the games. I can just stream them from my PC onto that PC. All my games that have downloaded on here showed up on there and I go click on it. and it says stream. You can stream the game from this computer down there.
Really?
Yeah. Did not know that was a feature.
What?
Steam adds shit. I have no idea it's there. So if you and your wife share a Steam account.
Oh.
All she has to do is just click a stream and it just starts playing.
You know
playing.
Why?
Why?
Steambox.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just saying, like, you've got all your, you've got your catalog downloaded on your computer.
Right.
You have a Steambox in your living room. Fuck downloading the game. I've got it downloaded on my computer. I'll just stream it.
I was playing GTA 5 on my Vita from upstairs, downstairs.
Can you buy a Steambox yet?
There's Alienware Alpha. It's like $399. It's a Steambox, basically. Okay. It runs the Steam OS. With a, it has an Alienware built OS on it, so you can control it with a controller. But it's a Steam box.
It's real unfortunate that they like released all that shit about their Steam controller, and then it kinda just kind of like what happened to that?
I'm pretty sure it'll come back because they already said they axed that and are revitalizing it.
I think I think that they had like such mixed reviews on that controller.
Yeah, I was interested what it was going to be.
I like the idea of like an old mouse pad. Type deal being your joystick, like I could see it, like it just.
But my only problem is sometimes my fingers have gunk on them, and that will ruin the entire experience because you'll skip over.
If they had like perforated, like it was like a PlayStation 4 remote pad?
Yeah, with the pad.
Could you do that?
I don't know.
I'm just talking.
It looks. I mean, it looks cool at the time.
Yeah,
but you never know. It's cool. I want to see what they do with that. I was hoping for an actual dedicated Valve-created Steam box, so it's all in one spot. But Alienware is something you can trust for something that's overpriced. But, you know, they make PCs, they know PCs, and they have decent hardware inside that machine. So. But if you could stream it from this computer onto something smaller onto my TV, that's pretty fucking amazing. And if it runs well, it shouldn't not run well. It's on the same fucking network.
They've got...
The Vita, on the other hand, I can access
the Vita looks, it streams really well.
It's insane. I can do it from your house. I did it from your house and turn on. I can turn on from I'll be at your house or your house or your house.
Roadhouse.
And I can stream from the internet as long as my PS4 sits up to the internet. Mm-hmm. I can turn it on and then turn on GTA 5 and play it on my Vita from that house.
And it streams it streams well enough to where you can play as a second player. Like me and my wife were playing Little Big Planet together.
Yeah.
And I was playing Little Big Planet on the Vita from another room while she's playing it in the living room. And I'm not having any problems, like, playing with my wife.
That's good. I'm glad to know your sex life is still good, man. Yeah. Yep. Hasn't dwindled that fast.
Just you know, hanging in there. Just doing the thing.
Just doing this and just sitting there for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. Stage fright. It happens to all of us. Either way.
Roadhouse.
My question for you guys is...
You haven't drank, so you losing yet.
Two-part question. They coincide. CG gets the first one. Halo 1.
Master of Puppets.
Was Halo 1 playable online?
No.
Wrong. Halo 1 came out on both the Xbox and PC. PC version actually had online play.
Well, you're Aaron, about when it that's a trick. That's a trick question. That is a trick. That is.
What's this when it first came out on PC or on Xbox?
Xbox.
Xbox like by months. Years.
Exactly. No, it came out on PCs later though.
Xbox, and then it came out on PC by 2003. Right?
Yeah, okay,
it was years
that's
later.
Bullshit hey, man, question.
It actually came out. It actually came out on PC. Halo 1 around the time of Halo 2.
Listen. Halo 1, was it playable online?
That's a
and what'd you say?
Question.
You said no.
No. You should drink. Three
no,
shots for
Aaron,
that.
Alexander.
No, that's bullshit.
No, Aaron Alexander. What was in
you
Halo?
You can't say some shit like that around the PC gamer. I was waiting on Halo.
Halo. When Halo was first pitched at Macworld, because Halo was originally
he's
a Mac
still not
video
your
game.
Fucking
hold on. It was originally a Mac game. It was demoed with several weapons. The rocket launcher, which was later changed because it's an anti-air rocket launcher. The assault rifle as we know it. The MIDI gun, which never made it into the final game. And this gun. Gun I'm actually talking about, which is actually a gun you never see in Halo, but you only see it in Halo PC.
I'll drink a little
it would show up again later on in Halo 3, but you won't see it in Halo 1 or 2.
Well, I didn't play Halo on the PC.
It was two weapons, actually.
By the time it came out, Halo 2 was already out.
Halo on PC had two weapons in multiplayer that I think it may have been in single player. I don't know. I never played on single player. but it had two weapons that were not in Halo Combat Evolved for the Xbox. Two extra weapons that actually were awesome to play in Blood Gulch. Sorry, man. Playing Blood Gulch online was amazing. And by the way, you're still wrong because there is a way to play Halo online on Xbox. You downloaded this thing onto your computer.
See,
and
we talking. God damn it.
It would spoof the Xbox.
All right, you win. What up? All right, Corey, what up?
No, hold on. God damn. Aaron's got to answer.
I don't fucking drink. Know.
The flamethrower and the grenade launcher.
Oh, yeah. I do the gas launcher
or whatever it was called.
Yep. I'll drink only because you're right.
Yeah. I remember finding that out. I didn't know about it. And I was playing Blood Gulch, the demo, which was awesome.
Corey
yeah,
won't drink it. When other people are right, but.
What are you right about?
It's all right. He'll be walking on hot coals soon enough.
About you setting up a trick question.
It wasn't a trick question because you can actually play Xbox Halo online.
Yeah, but the, that's a, you it's, know it's that you set it. You know that's that you set up the.
I know.
Sure, there were lots of games that you had to do things that were outside of the game's normal programming.
But no game
to
was
make
so,
it work.
No
it like
game was
that.
So sought after that I actually played it.
Especially coming from a PC gamer. Yeah, sure, you could play games online with your friends. You could even spoof Doom and Wolfenstein to play games online with your friends if you knew how to connect with your friend's computer.
That's the same
and you
way
guys could do
more,
it.
Really.
But you had to go through a lot of trouble to make that
simple.
Shit happen.
This was simple. You downloaded a program on your laptop.
Yeah, okay. Sure. You download a program on your laptop and then connect your Xbox and whatever.
No, you say go to LAN and it would actually populate a lobby list and it showed you the lobbies.
Okay, but it wasn't originally set up.
I know, but Halo was
so
built
that you
with
could
Xbox
just go
Live
into
and mom, but Xbox Live wouldn't launch for another year, so they had to scrap that part.
It's the reason that games like Return to Castle Wolfenstein were so huge because those games were like, hey, you know what? You can now do this. This has been Experience Pints.
I didn't get to bitch about WWE, but we'll do that as audio? I don't know.
I can bitch about WWE for you. WWE sucks.
WWE
sucks. The Women's Entertainment Network sucks. And WWE sucks. That's the reason that the name WWE is so close to that network's name. They used to be called the WWF,
which was awesome.
Which
they added to
they had to change.
Thank you for joining us from Experience Pints. I'm Corey. This is Aaron. This is CJ. And what you gonna do, brother? When he unravels it for you, I have no good pun.
Ah!